deadlift position for me. Now here's a,
well, don't use a mixed grip because it's not that heavy yet, right?
It's a little weird. Okay, how many of you guys made your bellies tight before you went down? Did anyone forget? Yeah, stand back up. So what happens if I just go ahead and load my spine and then try to get tight? How's that gonna work? Let's go ahead and do that. Load your spine, now get tight. How's that working for you? Not good, is it? One of the strategies we're employing here is that I can idealize my spinal mechanics in an unloaded position. I can start where I finish, like Louis says, at the top, and this is the easiest place for me to approximate idealized spinal position and idealized spinal mechanics and idealized spinal bracing. Upright, organized, and then I can bias into that position of emphasis. By the time I'm all the way down here, unless I have supreme flexibility, and even with supreme flexibility, I now have to buffer the resistance of my hips, my hip capsules, the soft tissue, my hamstrings, and all I can do is triage what I think is a neutral position. And so I think I'll get into a tight position, I hope, and then I'll try to brace from that position, not good enough, and that's why we tweak our backs when we over deadlift. So we end up running up to the bar, and then what am I looking for? Tension, right? I can't pull yet, so what do? Now I'm tight. Feels good, right? And now I'm super broken and overextended. Can you see that? What happens if I have to run up to the bar and it's 300 pounds and I'm breathing hard? Is that going to be a problem? Yeah, especially if it's like this. I hope I can get tight. That's what we see, right? Because the mechanics. And so you may be able to do it when you're not breathing hard, but all of a sudden you run up to the bar and you're breathing hard and we have a disaster. Does that make sense? How about this? As we've gotten more sophisticated community, we're competing more and more in Olympic lifting, which is fantastic. So as I Olympic lift, one of the things I want to do is have the same start position every time. We agree on that? I pretty much want to practice my complex motor skill in the same sequence over and over again. That sounds familiar to some of you guys, right? I organize, I set up, I pull from the same position. But what happens if I don't have a strategy to get myself into the same position every time? It's sort of a Hail Mary. Three different pulls, three different outcomes. I don't know why I was missing my snatch today. It's so weird. What happens is that you've set your back angle three different ways. You've created tension three different ways. You've organized yourself three different ways. We want to minimize the deviation. We want to minimize the kind of the perturbations in that stabilization strategy, how you stabilize. We want to do the same thing every time, particularly when it becomes a complex motor skill, and all of a sudden there's a lot of things going on. I'm breathing hard, I'm almost in the pain cave, I really can't see anything, but there's 150,000 people cheering for me, and everything's getting small. I need to be able to walk up to the bar and get stiff and pull without having to make this a very conscious move. And so I want my default patterning to be safe and effective and efficient and the same every time. Does that make sense?